Hi, I'm Dr. Young. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. In this video, we are going to review how monopolists pick their products' prices and the quantity to supply to achieve their objective, maximizing their profits. Unlike firms in perfect competition, monopolists have market power, the ability to single-handedly affect market prices. If they are the only producer on the market, they can set nearly any price they want, and that becomes the market price. What price are they going to pick? To find a monopolist optimal strategy, we are going to assume that the monopolist, like any other firm, does not just want to increase its profits. It wants to get as much as possible. After all, who would want to leave money on the table? So the monopolist will need to solve this problem. What quantity should it supply the market in order to maximize its profits? This is how this problem can be formalized mathematically. To find the optimal quantity to produce, we need to maximize the monopolist's profits, which is the total revenues minus total costs. How can we solve that problem? We simply take the first derivative of the profit function and set it equal to zero. If we do so, we find that the optimal quantity picked by the monopolist, QM, has an interesting property. It is the quantity at which the marginal cost, which corresponds to the supply function, equals the marginal revenue. We can then find the optimal price, PM, by finding the price that corresponds to QM on the demand function. Notice here that a monopolist produces way less compared to the supply in a perfectly competitive scenario, and charges a much higher price. Now let's focus on an important concept. What is the marginal revenue? The marginal revenue is the revenue gained by producing one additional unit of a good. It is calculated as the first derivative of the demand function with respect to the quantity. When the demand function is linear, like in our example, the marginal revenue of a monopolist is always a function twice as steep as demand. For instance, if the demand is P equals 10 minus 3 times Q, then the marginal revenue is the first derivative of this function with respect to Q. Since the demand is linear in Q, we know that the first derivative is a function twice as steep as demand. Marginal revenue equals 10 minus 2 times 3Q, which equals 10 minus 6 times Q. If we assume that the marginal cost of production is 2 plus 2 by Q, then we can find QM by setting the marginal cost equal to marginal revenue and solving for Q. We get that QM is equal to 1. Substituting QM in the demand function, we get an optimal price PM equal to 7. Let's get back to the optimal choice of the monopolist. Having picked PM and QM, the monopolist producer surplus is equal to the yellow shaded area. You can see that by picking any other feasible combination of price and quantity, the area that corresponds to the monopolist's surplus is going to be smaller. Now you know how monopolists find the perfect profit-maximizing price and quantity. Visit us at Chegg for more videos on this and other topics, or to seek help from a Chegg subject matter expert. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.